participates only if there's not a quorum. So the question was whether we want this at all, or we want to bring it to the full council. My thinking on this, and I know already that Lynn doesn't like this idea, because I asked her. My thinking on it is that you avoid a situation where there are multiple council members who want to be on a committee, and the president wants to be on the committee, and he or she chooses herself over a council member. Mm-hmm. And then since we've delegated all this authority to the president, we've even allowed them to choose themselves in preference to someone else. So that was my thinking. Then I also noticed in Northampton that the president is not on any of their committees. So I think what the president of the council in Northampton is doing is saying, I can participate on committees, so I don't have to be on a committee.
Right.
Then Mandy's concern, and I'll let her speak for herself, my husband raised this when I asked him about it, and then Lynn raised it with me, that does that mean that the president has to attend all council meetings? Mm-hmm. So I don't see any reason why, if we gave this authority, that the president could say, I'm going to be an ex officio member of committee one and two, meaning I'm going to kind of regularly come, but not of others, because she has the right in our overseas committees to go whenever they want.
Right.
So I thought this was a protective thing to put in, which is why I put it. So that's why I yellow highlighted it, that this is not in a ton of them, but I found five or six towns that did it.
And so this precludes her from being part of a committee?
Well,
she's ex officio of all committees.
It doesn't literally say she can't appoint herself.
Okay.
It doesn't.
Well, we would need to clarify that if we went with this plan.
So it doesn't say she can't, and since the charter says the president appoints all committee members, it doesn't then say, and then it later says the president shall have the same rights as any other council member, to vote, to do whatever. So it doesn't restrict the president from appointing herself or himself.
It's just suggestive.
It's just suggestive, and it's a way of, for example, I'll give you on finance. I went back and looked at where people had done their preferences.
Yeah.
And in finance, if Lynn hadn't appointed herself, we wouldn't have had five.
Yeah. Right.
Literally no one else had listed it as a first, second, or third choice. So she had to go down to second choices even to get to five people.
Yeah.
So in that case, we would have been short one person, and she would have had to, like she did with audit committee,
so
doesn't someone want to be on?
Yeah. So it makes sense to allow her to to do that.
Okay, so I'm going to weigh in, and I don't like any of this.
You don't like it?
I appreciate that other communities are doing it, and that's what we were researching, is what other communities were doing. I think the president should be able to be a member of a committee. I do not think a president should be an ex officio of any of the other committees. I think that it is obvious, based on my experience, that person has a chilling effect on every committee meeting they come to, because they're the president. And so people on the committee are working to please the president at the point when the president's there, especially if it's an ex officio basis rather than they're present. Any council member can come to any committee. I have no idea why we would give the president additional authority at our individual committee meetings by being a member of a committee, unless they're a full member of the committee. I think it's, I think that if I'm outvoted and you guys do it this way, it should be specified. You can't be both ex officio of everything and also a member of something like that.
You can't double dip.
But if you really want them to be ex officio of everything, then it seems like they shouldn't be member of anything. I would rather it's the way it is right now, in this temporary basis where we are right now, where is that she's a member of some things, or the finance committee in particular, and in fact in some communities she's automatically the finance committee.
Okay, so
I'm not seeing the purpose of having her be an ex officio member who can come and go as an ex officio member, not count toward quorum, not be depended on to attend every meeting, not be required to attend every meeting, because she's already got way too many responsibilities elsewhere. And then then say, but when she's there, it's like she's a member of the committee. I don't see the purpose.
Can I just add one thing to that? Because I saw in Mansfield, I think, it said all councillors shall be ex officio members of the committees to which they are not assigned.
I found that in several texts.
That is another interesting way of doing it.
Yeah, so that means anyone can, and all of us can, including the president.
So I didn't put that in, but I found it and I really liked it, and I thought people would hate that idea.
Well,
but
I like
that
idea.
So what would that mean? That would mean that all of us could attend any committee meeting, and
so again, we could do it,
but not have no voting because you could restrict it
to have no vote.
But we
and
can
motions.
Participate
no motions.
As an equal around the table at another committee meeting. But
right.
Just not be able to vote.
No, you
right.
can't make motions and can't vote.
And I asked Margaret about this,
mm-hmm.
but I'm not always sure that Margaret knows the full AG world. So, number one, we run into a couple issues on this. I like this idea, so
yeah,
I'm not
yeah,
arguing
yeah.
against it.
Yeah,
you know, I like this idea.
Yeah.
So one of the issues we run into is we're starting with 5 people on a committee. So if 2 more people show up and are fully participate, it's a council meeting.
That should have been posted as a council meeting.
That should have been posted.
Otherwise, people are going to assume you're deliberating about things
right.
that are for the full council. And in fact, you are. Because if you've got 7 people there,
right.
you are in fact delivering something because the committees serve a function to represent
right.
to the rest of the council what the council might want to do.
So I found an AG, I went on, to see whether I actually Googled council members participating in a committee on which they're not a member, and I found 3 or 4 AG decisions. It's, you know, it's a nice searchable thing. So one is one council had appointed a committee that had there were nine councillors, and they had a 5-person committee, so it was already a quorum of the council. And the AG said, perfectly fine. You could have a committee that is a quorum of your council as long as it only talks about things in its jurisdiction. So it can't go broader than whatever, you know, so you could have a big committee if you wanted. The second was this situation we're talking about, that it was a topic that was of high interest and 2 more councillors came. And there the AAG said if they sat over there not here.
Like residents.
It was fine.
Yeah.
And they weren't behind the bench. If they sat at the table, it had to be posted as a joint meeting, where the meeting was the finance. In this case, it was a finance issue, so it was. It was a finance committee meeting, but it was jointly posted with the chair. So it ran into this, you could do it as a committee, but you had to co-post it. You know, which would mean, you know, anytime 2 of us showed up, we'd have to know in advance that more of us were coming
right.
to be able to post
so
it.
I
just figured
it
out.
All counselors being accepted.
So we moved from just the president, which Alyssa doesn't like, you don't like, and Lynn doesn't like. I got an independent that Lynn doesn't like it. And she didn't like it for a similar reason you raised, Mandy, that does it impose an obligation to be attending all meetings?
Mm-hmm.
And then it's clear that president shows up, president has a different kind of authority than the rest of us, and if they can come dropping in sometimes and not other. So I think we're removing president. The question would be, do we want to enable any council member to go to meetings of others without voting privilege? In this case, it would be without voting rights.
Mm-hmm. So we saw that in a couple of other councils, like Mansfield and all that. All councils can be able to show.
Right. A few councils gave that right. And the issue we run into quickly is we've got 5 member committees and 7 are a quorum. So as long as only 1 shows up, we're okay. And if 2 show up, then we should have posted it as a joint, as a.
I appreciate the idea of we, but we haven't agreed to anything yet.
No. I mean the larger.
If it's done, the committee would have needed to post it.
Right. No, I'm talking about this committee before you got here. So I objected on certain grounds. You objected on certain grounds. Lynn objected on certain grounds. I also object to the idea of all counselors being ex officio, too. I understood the concept. I have understood the concept.
Mm-hmm.
I think that it does not at all recognize the practicality of the fact that certain people don't get appointed to committees and certain people do. And as soon as you put the other people at the table with almost the same membership as others, now you've just put that person on the committee after all. And so this is not a kumbaya kind of thing. These are councils, that committees that have been assigned to do specific tasks. If you have a strong personality who wants to come to every single council committee because they just happen to have the time and the energy to do that, they will influence every single council committee's work, I believe, in an untoward way. And I just, that practically speaking,
okay,
my
so Alyssa is
I'm
a
really
strong no to the
strong
idea.
No.
So I think, sorry, I was late.
No, you're fine.
I'm glad to see it moving off just the president.
Yeah.
So, and I had other reasons for objecting to the president beyond some that were stated. But I think my concern for everyone goes to some of what Alyssa said, but some of just the practical purpose. If you make it all practically, then every council meeting should be, I'm thinking about the workability, then every committee meeting, practically, if you've said everyone's ex officio, then really every committee meeting should always be noticed as a council meeting, because, or you make it incumbent upon anyone who might want to go that one day,
right,
of notifying someone in advance within more than 48 hours so that you
right
can do that notice, because otherwise someone might show up, but three people might show up, or two people might show up, and then they're no longer ex officio because you didn't notice the council meeting. And so what's the practicality of doing this if you don't ever want to say, oops, we didn't notice it as a council meeting, so yeah, you're ex officio, but you can't sit at the table, so now you can't comment except during public comment.
Mm-hmm.
That means every single committee meeting will need to be noticed as a council meeting.
Right.
And that, to me, is impractical.
Yeah.
On many different grounds. It creates just scheduling issues, because you also then can't have
you don't
two committees meeting at the same time.
Yeah, you don't know when they're coming.
You
yeah
don't, you know, in terms
you don't
of
know how many are coming and who
money
is coming.
You don't know. Someone has to keep track of, do you need minutes of that meeting for the council, or do you not? Do you, how do you declare? You know, just all sorts of practical reasons.
This is all the minutes-taking problem.
No, but it wouldn't, because the clerk wouldn't be at every council committee meeting. That's the thing. The clerk wouldn't be at every committee meeting. So I think from a logistics point of view, that idea is going to be really hard to implement.
Okay.
And that goes beyond whether I like the idea in terms of what Alyssa said. It's just logistically.
Unless we saw,
I can't
unless we
imagine
saw a really good reason.
Okay, I'm taking
well, we, you know, if other towns do it, they have figured that out somehow.
That's not a safe assumption. They could
no
be breaking open
the
wall
every
week.
Out.
Yeah.
I mean, they are operating logistically. I mean, they are doing it, and they have to follow
they,
the
they might never
laws
notice them as council meetings and just regularly break open meeting
we
law.
Know
and
people who break
the
open
law
meeting law every
yep
single week.
Yes, so this, so I'm just, I didn't
okay
yellow highlight C in here. We're working through, Mandy, I saved the clerical edit Mandy version as V1.
Okay.
So we're working off that right
okay
now, and I'm just, as people wipe things out or add
mm-hmm
things, so this is the work in progress. So I just removed President C, which is now C. I should have yellow highlighted this, as counselors who are not members of the committee are entitled to participate in the discussion of the committee. Newton had
that. I
like and
that.
And so this
as
is
as residents. Come on.
That's not what that says.
No, that's not what
that
says.
Not
no
what that says, Shalini.
Yeah,
that says
see
participate
oh, that's,
in the
but that's
discussion.
Like
yes,
kind
it,
of
yeah
similar
this
idea
is a nicer
so
way of this is a nicer way of saying
see,
it.
See,
but it
I
says
see,
it,
okay
it practically means the same thing,
okay,
and it practically
oh
runs
was
into the
yeah
same
okay
posting problems.
Oh yeah, yeah. I
it's
was
exactly
reading it more
the
as
problem
they can participate
yeah
as.
Okay, so
residents.
We could very clearly state, and in fact we should, directly because of this conversation, we should very clearly state that, without saying of course town councilors can participate as can members of the public.
Yeah.
Right, that they can feel free to attend, they can feel free to comment, but they are not going to be at the table. We should state that flat out.
So,
so this
could be restated then, councilors are not members of a committee or entitled to participate as members of the public.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Yeah, we should clarify that. Because I'm just saying, there's a value in that because I know that I am looking for different, you know, different people are researching different things, have different experience, and so we as a committee have been working under a certain lens, and someone else comes and says, hey, did you look at that? I mean, that should be an option. It shouldn't be, you know, we're all working towards the same goal of coming up with the best solution.
Right, and there may be some issues, you know, that we run into as we're getting to the end of this process that we actually don't agree on, and we can have a vote. It's not a big deal.
Nope.
You know, we don't have to have like 100% consensus on every single thing.
Right.
So.
So on C, I just
used to that myself.
So Darcy, on C, I just edited it to who are not members of the committee or entitled to participate as members of the public. So this is one where do we have, that one is clearly, we have the right to do that, period. So that's just a statement
just
of our rights. So
we're
making it. So the question is, are there enough of us who would like the larger entitlement to take a vote on this? That's what I think you're suggesting.
Is that
on
what you're
this.
Saying?
Yeah.
For this particular thing?
Yeah,
are we
on this issue,
general?
You know, which was, would be fine with me.
Yeah, I like the idea of, I didn't know this conversation was going to evolve into this, but I do like the idea of the ex officio, you know, members being ex officio members of any committee that they feel like going to, with, you know, the practicality is that all of us are so exhausted that we're never going to make those meetings anyway.
Yeah.
But,
of a culture of like trust and all, or is it like, you know, that it's like, hey, we're all in this together, and even if you're going off as a group, you know, I can still come in and listen and participate as, or like you all said, it is logistically so hard and it feels like someone's imposing and watching you and being monitored, or, you know, if it's creating those feelings should not even be there. So if they're there, that's a problem to begin with. Like, we should not be feeling that with each other. And
I think it could create some, and I have a request for a clarification on the new C, but
okay.
To address Shalini's issue or question, it could create some difficulties with the committee itself in terms of the committee's deliberations.
Jeez.
I'm thinking if, you know, I'm thinking of a committee I'm on where we've had discussions over 4 or 5 meetings on one subject. And if one person shows some, another counselor shows up at the first one, and another one shows up the third one, and another one shows up the second, and another shows up the fourth, that group, those individual counselors don't have the entire discussion in their history. And so they're jumping in, and they might run in with something that was already discussed two meetings prior, that then this committee might have to go back to, or would sound like if they said, you know, we discussed that 3 meetings ago, and we're over here,
as if
they're dismissing
those
counselors'
okay.
concerns. So, you know, I don't know.
I
see problems with it, even though I see a potential for good from it. But I think at this point I see more problems.
Okay.
To go to a clarification, I think it reads right now, counselors who are not members of the committee are entitled, could we make it clear that it's a council committee?
Okay, I just have to say that my internet, I just got thrown completely off.
I wondered because it didn't show your change you'd already
I'm
written.
Completely gone.
It's really
it
small
says,
bars.
It says I have no internet.
I've got really small bars too.
And I didn't, I can't download the document because I can't get on SharePoint. So what do I have to do, reboot? So if anyone else who's on it, stay on it. Don't lose it and save it because I didn't save it to my drive.
Your last save isn't showing up on the SharePoint. when you altered C and D, because D was the one for Newton, your rephrasing isn't showing up
okay.
in the shared document.
Well, I'm not on. That's because I'm just not on.
It just kicked you off. Yes, I've got really small bars.
Okay, so anyways, anyone who's on it, I'm just going to restart. I'm restarting my computer.
Okay.
I have no internet.
Okay, I like that point. That makes sense logically.
I mean, I think
so,
that you should look at the example of what's happened with me missing several of these meetings, is that it's really difficult, right,
yeah.
to catch me up
okay.
on.
Sure.
But we already went down this direction over here,
mm-hmm.
and even though we're not talking about this thing for the first time, it's related to that thing
right.
back there
right.
that we already
logically.
Did.
No,
and so
some,
it's not that you're trying
yeah.
to shut people out.
Right.
There are counselors, respectfully, oh, we're glad they came,
yeah.
but I have... Practically
yeah.
speaking, beyond the meeting
right.
agendas, the
right.
meeting minutes,
okay.
I have experienced counselors who then come in and then
mm-hmm.
try and take charge of every single meeting,
mm-hmm.
and they have the right if you've given them the right.
Yeah.
Whereas when you make it clear, hey, it's great you're here.
Yeah, we're going to have rare examples, but there
but
would
no,
be
I
the examples would be where someone actually is perfectly willing to commit to going to every single meeting. And we just
mm-hmm.
restricted the number of people, so and they had always said that, you know, there won't be that many, you know, so it's not that they want to go to all the meetings, there was just, they wanted to be on a committee.
You're working theoretically, I'm working practically, and I know what happens when
yeah.
you have a person
and
who comes
I am
and
working,
decides.
Melissa, I am working practically because I am personally going to every meeting of one of our committees that didn't have enough slots.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so, it,
so
I'm
it's great
saying,
that you go, and I hope they're listening to you at public comment, but why would you get to participate?
Mm-hmm.
Right, and that is, I...
So, I mean, I think going beyond personalities, individuals, I think just having that, I mean, so
it's
what
bad.
You're raising is a question that if someone was left out just because of the size of the committee, like community resources, so many of us, so is this a way, I mean, that's something to just question, is that one way we're allowing more people to participate in a committee they really wanted to be in, but because of our limitation, they were not. So that's an independent of who and what,
yeah.
that's
yeah.
a question.
I'm fine.
You can't write the rule for
no.
just that
yeah.
circumstance.
I am
if everyone's
no.
an exhibition of everyone, then
right.
you get the in and out
right.
circumstance.
Right.
Well,
yeah,
and it's
right.
not fair to pressure them to come to
right.
every single one either, just like
mm-hmm.
when we took off having the president there. It was not reasonable to have the expectation they should come to.
Okay.
Oh, do we feel like we want to have a vote on it? Because we could do that now. And you know,
while
I'm
we're waiting
willing
for the
to
internet
that,
to turn on something.
Yeah.
What about instead of a vote?
Just
I don't know
discussion.
Where people are saying and where the vote would end up,
yeah.
but a maybe write it without ex officio, assuming that might be where the vote ends up. If it ends up the other way, write it that way. But then in the report that goes to the council, specifically
mm-hmm.
highlight this issue as,
mm-hmm.
you know, we've said that with some other things.
Yeah.
And maybe have wording ready for the other one.
Yeah.
Okay.
You know, here's
yeah.
our two
good.
Okay, so
options.
And also, I'm just conscious of the time, so we can...
Yeah,
yes,
yeah.
yeah.
okay.
so
okay.
we can
just
time
say,
check it half an hour, and it's been...
We have a split on this.
Okay, so tell me, I'm back on, so how do I write...
Is that your suggestion?
Maybe
yeah.
I think two versions.
One is
of
the
is
one that whatever the majority here supports, the other one's ready to go.
Right.
In
okay.
case that one, and then it's brought
right.
up in a report that says, here was one of the issues we split, this is the one that had the majority in the town, this...
Right.
In the committee, this would be the other one.
So, Mandy,
right.
tell me how you rewrote C. I was, because I was
okay.
trying to reboot my
oh,
counselors
oh,
who are not members
C.
of the
so,
committee.
So, it would be counselors who are not members of council committees. Or a specific, I don't know, I just wanted to make clear it was council
right,
committees.
Right, yeah, not about conservation
committees. We're not talking about town
committees.
And not members of council committees are entitled to participate as. Members of
the public,
is that how it was originally?
Yeah, okay, yeah, I'm just talking it now, and I'm going to avoid this happening again by also saving
yeah.
shit.
Excuse so if
me.
We can just write two options, and then we can vote later at some point
okay.
in the process, A, that those are the two options, and then maybe, as we get through more of this, we'll come to coalesce around one of them anyway,
mm-hmm.
as completely, rather than as
right.
a split vote. But at this point, if we just write up two alternatives, we'll just say, choose your path, A or B.
So I guess the other one would then come counselors shall be ex officio. I'm just looking at the former C.
Yeah, I just read in Mansfield, all councillors shall be ex officio members of the committees to which they are not assigned, but do not have the authority to make motions or to vote.
Oh, that's a good word.
Okay.
Say that again.
Members. So where
I'm
is
typing
that?
It.
All councillors shall
but
be.
But I'm saying, is it?
It's not in there.
Okay.
I'm typing it in.
Say that again.
All councillors shall be ex officio members of the committees to which they are not assigned, but do not have the authority to make motions or to vote.
The authority to make motions
or to vote.
Or to vote.
And you can see of the council committees.
Yeah.
Okay. So that includes the president.
Yep.
Yeah. And that
would go to
yes.
everyone. Yeah.
It just doesn't treat them differently because they're president.
Okay, so I have made this.
One, option two.
Yeah. We'll figure out how to do that.
Since they conflict with each other.
Yes.
It's clear we know they conflict.
We are aware of this choice. There's a little arrow here that says pick one.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay, so I just did it now, if people can see what I'm typing on. I did it as a bullet underneath C, and it says option two. That was the easiest way of notating it right now,
mm-hmm.
until I download it to Word where I can make C option A, C option, you know, option one and option two. Because this automatically, someone else is typing on it, but this automatically.
They both say town now.
Mm. Oh, no,
town,
we're not doing town.
We're just doing town, we're just,
we're
doing,
just
council.
Doing council.
Okay.
Council. Yeah.
All right, my mistake.
Okay, so
if that does get voted in, that all councillors shall be ex officio, I think it's on the councillor that they will not be imposing themselves, knowing that certain decisions have been made.
Right, we'll have a behavioral.
Yeah.
Yeah. Talk to Hadley. I can give you some other examples. Talk to Hadley about how you control your members. You can't.
You can't.
You can't. This group of 13 gets along beautifully. Yeah. You can't control your members.
Creating complexity and problems, it's better to go with the simpler, cleaner option.
Okay. Gotta get back to okay. Can I just delete the very beginning now? So I'm just trying to get to a cleaner copy.
Yeah.
You know, that very beginning, standing committees agreed on. That's just
everything before council committees and committees
yeah,
of the town.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Got it. I'm just getting rid of it.
That's all from the whole outline.
Yeah.
Right, just
remember
just stuff piece parts, right.
Outline, so.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Okay, so the next thing.
Are we comfortable with the select committee section? We haven't talked about
that.
No, we're just moving
yet.
Right down.
Yeah.
So
wait, can I just clarify one thing? The G point, all council committees shall be advisory to the council and take no actions that bind the council. So that just sort of links back to the OCA decision that they made.
I actually have a notation on the
things
that turned into V1 were just like anything that wasn't really
substantive.
This my substantive here was, what does this mean?
Which letter? I heard what you said.
Okay, we're now in F.
Oh, it's
okay.
A new one.
No, new F.
It's
new
F. It's the last one under this one. All council committees shall be advisory to the council and take no actions that bind the council. It might be reworded better, but it's, you know, that what a committee comes up with is a recommendation that to the council that the council then votes on. That's the intent of something like this, that they're not making a decision before bringing the decision back up.
That's not true.
Yeah, and the OCA just
where
in F.
It's
new
F.
F.
Oh,
F.
The
OG.
Right there.
It's
oh,
what
okay.
F.
Okay. Yeah.
That's not actual fact at this point.
Right, it may not be fact. It's a proposed.
Right. I mean, it's the question is, what are the pros and cons of?
Yeah. And I still go back to, what does this actually mean?
Well, it could be rewritten. What it means.
What does bind?
What does bind mean? What does advisory mean? No act. I guess I read the thing and I go, what are the limitations of this? What are the restrictions? I just don't know.
Okay,
what.
Let's talk about the.
Okay.
So then
I think if it were reworded to have more meaning, it would be reworded to say, it was one of the conversations we had within the newly formed community resources that things would be referred to the committee.
Right.
The committee would do more research, do more, and make their recommendation up to the council, and then the council would make the decision. So it's that's the flow of it goes to the committee to do thorough work on it, to come back and say what you think.
Mm-hmm.
That what the committee comes up with is not final. It's mm-hmm. the council that comes final. So this should be reworded that's the intent of it, I think.
It makes recommendations.
I
think that actually that's entirely covered by the charge of each committee. Each committee's mm-hmm. charge should indicate what their powers are. And rather than trying to write a blanket statement that's going to cover every charge, because there are going to be certain council committees, whether you call them ad hoc or working groups or task forces or whatever, that are assigned to do a specific thing, but then bring it back to the council. There are going to be others who are told, make this much happen, and then come to the council.
Mm-hmm.
Like, we have a disagreement on OCA, but nonetheless, that at this point, it's advise the town council on appointments. It's not
mm-hmm.
take your process to the town council for appointments. So I'm not sure that this helps us at all. If our charges didn't
okay.
say.
I understand your point of view, and I'm going to come back to it, Alyssa, then I would go back and rewrite that charge because I didn't. Some of these charges, when we looked at them when they first went through,
we didn't know this.
I was trying, you know, we've got another thing, duties and powers of councils coming up too, where we could do this. So what you're saying is a blanket statement may not make sense, but examining every charge to make sure where we've delegated final, on what aspects we've delegated final authority to a committee and where we've asked them to come up with a recommendation should be clear. And that blanket, I think that's what you're saying. So
yeah.
I would agree that the charge should be really clear. You know, finance is totally clear. The charter makes it clear that the only thing finance is doing a thorough vetting and bringing its recommendation back to the council.
Right.
We can't encumber, spend, do anything else as a committee, right?
Right, and I don't see a particular purpose for ever giving a committee the authority to act on its own, because it's only five members of the council.
Appointments, do they make the appointments?
We just recommend.
I could see it in the future where you start getting potential bylaws that come through the planning board side, and the committee says, this just isn't ready for a vote, and just ships it back to the planning board without it ever coming back to the council. Like the five members agree
right.
and say, this is not ready for action. It's not that we agree with or not agree with the policy, but it's not. It hasn't been thoroughly vetted. It hasn't had its pros and cons. It hasn't had this.
Mm-hmm.
Or a resident initiative. I can see where it could. There could be a committee that a decision that says we're not. It's not ready to come to the full council for debate on the merits.
What's the problem with just coming back with a recommendation to the full council saying that, and then we all just ship it back to?
Well, it's an efficiency thing.
Yeah.
I think that was where Evan was getting with the TMAC proposal. We pretty much debated the merits, and I think his point was potentially. Is this the place to debate the merits? Is it ready to debate the merits now?
Right.
Or is the merit debate at some later time? I'm putting out there that I could see a point in time, year two, three down the road when we've got better systems in place. We're so new. We're still trying to figure out whether our charges are accurate to what we want committees to do, but I can totally see a future of a council where the committees can say this isn't ready for prime time. And so we're not going to bring it back to the council to say this isn't ready for prime time, debate whether it's ready for prime time. Get it ready for prime time.
Okay, so the so Mandy, the example you gave is a good one, why if it's not ready for prime time and you want to go to the group to come back with a revision or make it clear or something, the other example would be is first time through, councils are coming up with ways of doing things that will be our way of doing something as a whole council, and we haven't heard a rationale why, so it's a process. So they're putting in place a policy, which policy slash practice, and I don't think we should be authorizing five people to do that before we've heard why, considered it, and said, yes, that makes sense to me. So if we've inadvertently done that without realizing, because we didn't carefully word a charge, so this may not be written in the right way, that like no action ever. No action ever, but
what,
it's...
What are you here for?
The resident advisory committee.
Oh, yeah, that's not that.
Yeah, so Mandy, I'm just saying that the example you gave is like, it's not ready yet, we need more information, I want committees to do thorough vetting and do assessments of before it's ready for a vote, but to actually implement a process that will, in fact, bind the council, and we only have one example coming up to us, seems quite different than that.
We don't really have one example. GOL has implemented a process for reviewing things addressed to it for clarity, consistency, and actionability.
Mm-hmm.
We told you what that process, we told the whole council what that process was in a document.
Right, and we agreed,
so
and we said that,
she didn't put it up for a vote.
There was no vote.
She said
that.
It is what it is.
It is what it is.
What do you mean there was no vote?
There was no vote on the process we used to on what we define clear to mean, what we define consistent to mean, what we define actionability to mean. There was no vote in the council on that. It was brought in a report and says, here's what GOL has come up with on how it's going to review these matters. Here's what the template for charges are that we're going to base charges off of. The council did not vote on that template. The council did not vote. So it's not just OCA that has done, it's a process the committee uses. The committee could change that process at any time as committee members change. Or a
councilor, it's really interesting. It's really interesting, Mandy, because as you talk, you
could say, hey, I want to vote on that, and then the council could decide whether or not to vote.
So here's where I just find it's the two examples are really good ones, because I have no problem with someone coming up with a totally logical format for things that just takes things we've already written and puts them in the right place, and consistent, and saying we've been asked to vet things using these three words, therefore we had to define the three words, and this is, so that to me is like we've already said do that. It feels totally different to me than saying the charter said the council shall appoint the planning board. And I always assumed 13 of us would somehow know who's applied, understand what the interviewing process was. And this is a brand new thing that has never been done before. And if whatever path we're going, see, I don't even understand what the thinking was behind the process, but that is, we are actually setting up a regulatory authority in town that's external to the council that then will be making judgments in a major way about zoning. So it seems such a higher order, and it may be the charge had to be rewritten to make it clear that that is a bigger thing than you in GOL saying, what should the format of a charge look like? Lynn had to wing it first time through, and then you came back and took more or less the starting point and said, I'm going to make them look consistent with each other.
I understand the difference you're making, but both under current H.
Mm-hmm. Or F.
F. Neither of those could have been done. Even what GOL did to set up that process would have had to come back. Council. So the way all of this wording is, there's no...
Yeah, so this wording...
So, and
this wording is, I'm agreeing that this wording, so are we saying that a few of the charges need to be revisited, which is where Alyssa was, it was started with, on which things do we want to come back, where the authority to come up with a way of doing something has clearly been given to the committee,
mm-hmm.
and we want them to come back with, this is how we're planning on doing it, versus we're giving the authority and we want you to just do it. Tell us how you're gonna do it, but just do it.
Yeah, I don't think there's any harm in asking committees to come back on all major policy decisions.
And see, that's what Mandy is doing, the blanket, Dorsey, it says no action, so, and what's the difference between major and minor would be?
That's really hard to define.
Right, I mean, you had to have
all
a meeting.
Go back to my legislative process when
you
I was
had,
trying to
So Mandy Jo had to have a meeting or more to decide what clear, consistent, and actionable meant. Those three words might seem obvious to all five of us, but probably did not come out exactly the way each of us would have defined it based on what her group defined it as.
Mm-hmm.
So for any of us to decide what is major versus the rest of the county council
right.
deciding
no,
what is major.
I am.
I would say that should have come back to the council.
Okay, can I just make a comment?
Yeah.
In terms of practicality, let's say someone has, the committee has really worked through this, spent a lot of time, so they've gone through, and let's say we were to ask them to bring it to the whole town council, the amount of time they've spent thinking about it, we're not going to have that. And so how does, what can we add or do? I mean, what is the purpose of that process?
The purpose,
for us to be
okay,
made aware?
Here's the way I think of it,
yeah.
Coming from, again, it's my major experience as federal or state. If something was going to come in, new regulatory process, the deliberative group
mm-hmm.
comes in
mm-hmm.
with a clear one-page
mm-hmm.
summary that says, this was what we considered, we went through three options, this is the way we've done it, here's
mm-hmm.
the reason why,
mm-hmm.
period. So
okay.
we don't have to go through 20 hours of thinking about
right.
it. We thought
right.
of A, B, and C, and three were deemed to be illegal or
yeah.
whatever,
right.
and then we can understand the thinking
mm-hmm.
and look at the points at where if you've gone in a different direction, so for example, with appointment process, they go in a different direction, the interview would have had to be in public. What's wrong with that?
Mm-hmm.
Or we would have had to have applications be public. What's wrong with, there were, but I agree, we wouldn't
mm-hmm.
want to go through another
right.
20 hours.
But I do like that.
But
if
I want
you bring it in front of the council, it opens the whole thing up for debate and can result in a full rehashing of everything and a rewriting of that policy if you suddenly say, yeah, you guys spent 20 hours doing that, but I don't like it, or the five of us don't like it, and so we're going to rehash it all, even if that's where we end up, and then 3 hours into the meeting, of the council meeting, you're still talking about how the whole thing. To me, it comes, trying to look at it, and I'm trying to relate to how I feel about OCA. And what's coming, I think as a counselor that's not on that committee, I need to be able to trust the committee members, my fellow counselors, to have done that, and at least for processes that they want to operate under, to trust them that they've made a decision that is the best way for them to operate after they've instituted all of it. And if I come in after they've spent 20 hours and countless hours with the town attorney and all of this and say, well, I don't like it, go back and fix it. That almost...
No, I understand that perspective,
but
what...
I don't trust them.
Well, or I would have had...
Versus knowing what the policy is
yeah.
and just being it presented and saying, here's what it is for your information.
But let me do it that if a different five people had been in the room, so
mm-hmm.
it's they would have come to a different conclusion
mm-hmm.
because you felt there were a few strong voices that influenced the outcome. And there were 13 of us. And so if we had shuffled the deck
mm-hmm.
and put
you
five other people, you
yeah.
might have had a different
yeah.
cover page. That seems to me a very different situation.
But you can say that for any recommendation or anything coming out of a committee. committee, if it's a different five of us, it might have
so
come back
going
with a
with
different
that?
Representation.
Well,
finance committee is the same way.
Yeah.
Well,
for
right.
Five
so finance cannot make decisions without, we cannot.
But they have a process for figuring out whether it's, they're going to have a process. For
but
them.
You still have a role. And so to pretend that just because you don't have a final say, does you have a huge
influence
on what the town council is going to hear. And a different five would have a different huge influence.
It's the binding part.
I think I like the part that you said where we get a one-page report, because even we're answerable, like when I'm going to meet, you know, committee at district meetings and stuff, and people are like, how did you make that choice? And well, go ask Oka. Well, I should also know what that process was and why we chose this versus that.
And if I think about it a long time and I say I would not come up with that process, I ought to have some recourse as an elected official to be able to weigh in on it.
So you do. You say no to their appointment recommendations.
No, because it's...
No, it's a process.
It's the process of doing it.
But I'm not saying I want to go and say, no, like you spent all this and now I think I'm better and I know better. But I would like to be informed is what I'm
saying. That's part of the reports.
Yeah.
That,
and so
that to me sounds like we need extensive reports with
or that
how
one
you're
page,
doing the process.
Or at least that one page which said we had these options, we chose this over this because of this. I don't know how long that
I would consider that something that should be in a report.
Yeah.
On how you got
that should be the report.
Yeah.
Yes.
I've said this before, but you know, I just know I have constituents who want me to have a voice in the major decisions that we're making when we're forming our new government. And this would leave me out.
That's right. That's
you know,
right.
I wouldn't have a vote on it. I wouldn't have a say in how we're, you know, choosing our new, you know, if I weren't on OCA, I wouldn't have a voice and I wouldn't have a vote on how we did this. Yeah. And so I
guess I don't feel that way and I'm not on OCA. My vote is whether to confirm or not. That's my voice. And that is a, and I'll relate it back to another vote I've been taking and taking some hits for. My it's that OCA, you know, a vote on those appointments is not just these appointments are good, but the process is good. And I agreed with the process that got to it. It's why I've been voting no on all these public way requests, because I don't agree with the process at this point. And until we fix that process, those parking spots will be no. It's not that I don't agree with the marathon
Samantha,
or this
Samantha,
or that.
You're setting up, which is, I think, would be a very unfortunate situation, that if I don't agree with the process that I'm getting major appointment recommendations, that my only way of protesting the process is to turn down the appointment, which seems like a very...
But if we all did that, we would be saying no to the farmers. Like, if all of us were thinking like you are, then
we would all be saying
no to the farmers market parking and all of that,
which had nothing to do with farmers market.
Yeah,
but it has to do with the...
It was our bad that we didn't sit in. We're punishing the constituents
for that. Then we should set it better. And so if you get too many no's because of the process, that gives the committee, number one, an idea. It gives the council an idea. But there's also any councilor in any town council meeting can always, or go to the chair, the president, you can always, if there's a report there, you can say whatever that is. You could say, I want to vote on this. I think this is too important. And I think that was at our last meeting. Darcy, I think you...
Right.
Made a motion to do that,
and
the council voted against that motion, but the motion was made to say, this process here, or this decision here, even though it's an internal one, is too important to be done and left to just the committee. We as a council need to talk about it. You can always make that motion.
It takes a lot of, I mean, it's putting one person in a bad spot, like, oh, you're the one who doesn't think so. I mean, it should be, the process, it should be such that it doesn't put individual people in that sort of a spot.
So I think we've got a strong difference of opinion on this.
Should people go back and think about the person? Because, I mean, for me, what happened was, okay, there was a deadline that we, not, doing the appointments. And so I was like, we don't want to punish and hold that process up because of our, and plus I do know that you all have done a thoughtful, I mean, the committee has done a thoughtful thing, they've got attorneys. So I intrinsically, I trust the the outcome, and I know there's this time, and so I'm gonna say a yes. But we got the report like what, in the afternoon or something? There was no time to look at what was there and what.
And it wasn't
and
very
it was,
clear.
Yeah, and it wasn't like what was, why did we choose what? I mean, none of that was there.
Well, none of it was intended to be there because we didn't give you the process to.
So let's just, I want to use, I think we should get, divorce ourselves from this. This is what triggered it for me,
right.
Because I think what, so I'm going to try to move us off this because I don't think
we
have agreement on it, but I would strongly want, and we can have one of these options, you know, it's either out of here altogether or there's a something. That I think this notion that where it's the first time instituting a policy or practice that we will be following, it should be made as a recommendation to the council with a vote taken on. You know, I don't want to do this no action. This is too broad, no action ever that will bind it. So to try to rewrite it in a more qualified way. And to me, it's this first time through. Once we adopt a way of doing something, we're at least for the next 3 years going to do it, unless we,
maybe not.
Unless we then discover we hate it. But
yeah. If you hate it, then.
But when I find out Northampton is doing it in a different way than we are in this and others, once I have more information, and I wasn't there as a decision making, I feel like I need to be part of it. So, I would just say that F is either in, rewritten, and I'll take a stab at rewriting it, or out, and we come back to it next week.
Yeah, that's good. Yeah.
Okay. And we come back to it next week. So I'm going to yellow highlight it.
Mm-hmm.
That as written, it's. And I'll send people. I mean, Darcy and I both are advocates of something like this in here, but I'll just send two or three, like, here are four ways of writing one sentence that we can consider next time, right?
Yeah, and just the transparency of what is the process for the people and everything makes sense to you. Have it in a practical way.
Yeah.
And not in a way that I'm not trusting you, but more that it should all be out in the open of why certain decisions were made.
But
a practical way.
But it is all out in the open, and it will be more specifically out in the open when you brought your first.
Okay, it will be.
When,
and if that's
then
it's not
the
even an issue, then for me it's not an issue. If the process, like the report reports all of that, because then if I read the report, if I have any issue, I should be able to go to the people directly. Hey, I have a concern about this.
Mm-hmm.
And then you might say, hey, we thought about this and this is why it is. It doesn't have to take up the whole of town council meeting, but I could go to the chair of the committee. Is that what would happen? Right.
Should we use a different color highlighting on C to make it clear that it's a choose your own adventure sort of deal?
I'm gonna
be highlighted somehow so that we'll remember.
I'm gonna come back to it, Elizabeth. I just can't in SharePoint do the formatting that I can do in Word. It's trickier. So
I was just thinking of highlighting because I think
I'm gonna highlight. Yes.
What are we doing?
I'm just highlighting anything where there's not agreement on,
right.
You know, where it's a choose this
needs
or choose
to be a
this,
little
you know, rewarding. Option. So I'm going to go option.
There are different levels of rewording.
Yeah.
A certain shade of yellow means this, and a different shade of yellow means something else.
So are we down to
yes,
next.
Select committees now?
So could someone explain to me why we decided to call it this? Just is it because that's what a lot of other communities do?
Select committees, I think it we actually have.
Northampton has it.
I just purely, this is a copy and paste from Northampton.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. We have, and then I realized later, we have something called special committees referenced in, we might have special committees referenced. So
mm-hmm.
The notion was, this is what the notion of this thing is, that you might want to set something up that has a short-term duration focused on a particular issue.
Mm-hmm.
And it's not got rid of those words, standing committee.
Right.
You know, so it's dealing, I could imagine that when we first did marijuana, if we had had a council, we might have made a council's subcommittee that was dealing with this. And the special committees, as I understood, this is literally copy and paste, and I just took out the mayor and the town of Northampton from this.
Right.
This was Northampton wording, that in this instance, they brought on some residents and some town employees because you wanted the committee to come back with a new way or a different way or address something that hadn't been done. And I thought it's a nice idea, so I stuck it in. This was why I blue shaded it.
Yeah, I saw one in San Diego for homelessness, and I thought that was really great, that you could have residents, you could have, you know, different people be part of it, and then figure out an issue, and then you bring it back. And the way they had framed it, I liked the language, was to look at the legislative action needed, make recommendations to the council, and then fold that work back into a standing committee.
All that is understood. I just don't know why we're calling them select. We've had
ad hoc.
Oh,
no,
it's
no different. What's the difference between that and an ad hoc committee?
It's no different than what we assign.
I guess
you can't have outsiders, right? Ad hoc is just,
I think
no.
Any
you
can
be
in our
there's no such thing as a definition of ex officio. There's no such thing as a definition of
ad hoc. Our charter allows residents to be on any council committee if we so deem.
Okay, so the main thing you're saying is it's the word. So if we call.
To me, it wasn't necessarily, it was part of it was the wording of how is this different than ad hoc, and if it's not different than ad hoc, do we need to define it? That was my other thing, because, you know, like.
Okay, do ad hocs allow, you're saying ad hocs allow, they allow residents and other people?
Or we could stop calling things ad hoc. I'm saying choose one. So we could stop calling things ad hoc, and we could call them select, or we could call them special, or we could call them task forces, but we should pick something.
Yeah, if they're the same thing.
And
my assumption when I agreed with the select or special or whatever was that it's a little different from ad hoc, but if you're saying they're all the same thing,
yeah,
then just use one word.
Then the naming of it didn't bother me. I like the idea that we've only set it up for our own term, because we're not creating a standing committee. We're addressing a specific issue rather than giving it a broad charge.
Right. So we can call it just ad hoc committee, just make it clear that this could include.
What would GOL want to call it? That's what I
GOL has
to.
Already called them ad hoc.
That is a term.
Okay.
In the committee charge.
I'm
guess
okay
if they're not, if they don't have separate sort of purposes from what we typically think of as an ad hoc committee, I don't see the need to have this section in there at all.
Well,
I guess
where
that's
we define ad hoc committees then?
We don't.
That's what I'm saying, is we should someplace have a definition that indicates clearly for everyone that in addition to subgroups of counselors being assigned a task, we can also have another grouping that's around a particular issue that just as Shalini said, has residents, has other, you know, whoever needs to be at the table.
Yeah.
It's not just council committees.
Right.
So pick a term for that. And so if ad hoc is currently only applying to groups of town councilors, then I understand the purpose of having a separate name for this. But I understand that this concept actually applies to both.
Mm-hmm.
And so
to me it's
a special purpose committee, which is great.
Special purpose committee.
Special purpose committee, but what is that called? And do we need to specify that sometimes they'll be just counselors and sometimes they'll include others? Or do we just not even need to say, but we probably need to say in some fashion that it's okay to have a thing and what its nomenclature should be.
But see, we've got A under one way up at the top. In addition to the finance committee established by the charter, the council may establish committees and ad hoc committees by majority vote.
And ad hoc is literally listed in 2.6E.
Right.
Right? That term is actually in 2.6E.
Those are just committees of the council.
Yeah, but that's what a select committee is, based on what the who's appointing and all.
Well, that's
because right here, the select committee, the president appoints all members, which is the same as a council committee.
Right, but we're gonna. I see. You know, already. Every once in a while, I feel like I butt up against the charter, which was probably not intentional with it. Right now, the president shall appoint all members. It can include members of the public, town employees, and staff people. That starts to look like a multi-member body.
Mm-hmm.
And this is establishing a particular thing that allows our president to set the whole thing up with the town manager. I mean, the town manager would clearly have to approve a town staff person serving on a committee like this.
You'd have to just say the town manager or designee.
So yeah. I think our biggest problem here is actually seems really small. But under 1A, which you referred me back to, Mandy Jo, is we dropped some words out of 1A, and that's what makes a substantial difference in how we look at this. What the charter actually says is its own committee, standing or ad hoc committees. It does not say may establish committees and ad hoc committees by majority vote. And that actually does make a difference, because this whole section is about council committees and committees of the town.
So we should have the word council committees and ad hoc committees.
May establish, yeah, however you want to phrase it, but the words in the charter say shall determine its own standing.
Well, I guess one says process to establish council committees, and then A is in addition to the finance committee, the council may establish committees and ad hoc. So it's all under the heading one.
Since I would like to include those words, because that's directly what 26E says, in case somebody forgets to look at that heading that says process to establish council committees.
It's may establish its own?
Yeah.
Okay.
So we should just add its own between establishing committees.
Good.
Yes.
Yeah.
And its own committees, I don't know.
It should say standing. I mean, it says standing or ad hoc, so we can't just pick half of that. Okay. So either it's standing and ad hoc or it's not, but I mean, they're not capitalized in the charter.
Yeah.
Okay.
But standing and ad hoc committees. Okay. So standing committees, we already have a section for, which should now be item two, should now say
standing
council
committees.
Following
standing.
So that flows from standing down to two, and now standing. And then ad hoc committees we should describe, because ad hoc otherwise is not explained. And ad hoc should be explained, and perhaps the way to explain that, instead of saying select committees, say ad hoc committees, and then say you can make one, the council can make one that's just an ad hoc committee for a specific purpose, like we've already done, and just memorialize that. And then add to it that it can, in fact, also have residents and others on it with the wording you were thinking about for, you know, you can't compel the town manager to put somebody on it, but you're asking the town manager to put people on it. You can't say, I appoint Stephanie Chacron to this without...
Say the town manager or designee.
Right. Because then it flows. We got standing committees, we got ad hoc committees, and but we've got multiple kinds of ad hoc committees, not just the kind that's interior council ones, but that are still council. It's not like we're suddenly setting up a new multiple member body out in the town.
Right.
It's still our ad hoc for a particular purpose. This is not how you would run, like, you know, parking forever kind of thing. You wouldn't
so, but we're not talking about for only councilors, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
We're trying to clarify that it could be either.
You
it could be just councilors, or it could also be a larger group. It would depend on the issue.
So I had moved up the works or study groups to consider new measures. I thought I put it up there because I thought that was similar to these ad hoc committees.
I think the work group is the same thing.
Yeah.
And so maybe use some of that wording in there.
Council may establish ad hoc committees to consider...
Rather than saying for purpose of considering a particular policy or other purposes, maybe use your, if it, well, anyway, some combination.
There needs to be some sort of combination of
yeah.
Yeah.
Meld those together, and then it will cover both kinds of issues.
Right, so any or all of these types would be under the ad hoc committee, basically. They're all the same.
That's what it sounded like to me.
Yeah.
It's just figuring out how you
what we call things, right? And we, you know, in the past, the community struggled with that, too. Is that a work group, an ad hoc committee? Is it a standing committee? What does that even mean? So we'll finally define it somewhere, standing and ad hoc, and which GOL did also, but nobody had ever done
and,
it before.
And charter said ad hoc, so.
Right.
Okay.
And then specifically standing. So.
Then I'm going to leave this blue right now on the thing and download this document, because it says no committee will... It, and somewhere in the middle, I'll just say, ad hoc committees may include just counselors. They may also be broader. So
you could just say ad hoc committees may include residents.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah, and you could also, and you wouldn't necessarily appoint, and you know, we can argue about this for a while, but I think we could simply say you wouldn't necessarily appoint town staff to be a member of a committee. You would just ask town staff to participate, and that's what you're asking the town manager to do. And then if the town manager says, well, I want them to have voting rights, then that's a whole different conversation. But I think the important thing is you want their expertise.
Right.
And these groups are not necessarily likely to come up with split votes. They're more likely, they're just researching something for everybody else
or
to act on.
Proposing a marijuana bylaw.
Right, exactly. And so,
it shouldn't be a statement.
And I would like to make sure that when you're making, if you're the one making that pretty, Kathy,
yeah,
if you would break out in a bullet point that no such committee shall exist beyond the current term, I think that's really important to not have that in the block of text. I think, because I think you made a very valuable point there, that that is a thing. I know that formatting's a pain in the butt on this thing.
That's
but,
okay.
No committee should
exist.
So the ad hoc can't carry over.
Ad hoc committees are done at the end of our 3-year term. They don't move on to the next council term.
Because they should have resolved something by then.
They should have done their work.
If they haven't, then we probably need a different ad hoc, or we need a new standing committee, right?
Mm-hmm.
We might need a new, if it turns out the ad hoc's work just seems to be going on and on, maybe it's because there's a standing
mm-hmm.
committee that should be taking its place.
Okay, so I'm going to get rid of work committee, right?
But
because
sort of combine the two into
yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
And then work powers and duties. We should, if we're delineating them in the rules,
we should say
standing committees and ad hoc committees
under 6 in the title,
or whatever number it's added.
Yes.
Decision to make, even though it's not highlighted.
Oh, yeah, now they're all bullet points.
Okay, so is, did you just jump all the way down to everything in powers and duties is okay?
No.
Oh,
I got questions.
Okay.
I see some little.
So
some
B,
little
B, I've got a couple of questions on.
Okay, so mine is bulleted right now. I'm going to turn it back into.
That'd be awesome. Word is so fun that way. It just decides.
It just does stuff, right?
Okay, A. I've got them back into letters.
Thank you, Kathy.
Okay.
So I wanted to talk about B.
Okay, right. I didn't yellow shade.
You didn't yellow shade the
Sorry.
X committees. That is a decision that needs to be made.
Yes, I meant to.
Okay, what
I
needs to be highlighted?
The very end of B, there
yes.
was a thing that says about no council member may chair more than one standing committee unless there are more than so many committees.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
And so we would have to put a number in there.
Yeah. Can I vote for just take it off and let no more than one standing committee, period. And then, because I can certainly envision a situation where somebody who's a chair of a standing committee would also chair an ad hoc particular
okay.
thing.
Okay, I'm fine.
But do
as
we,
I said, I do, I'm not going to even argue for this. I
there's
this
just
is,
good ideas from other places.
Yes.
This was Kathy and Jen on January 4th.
I'm okay saying a council member shall not chair more than one standing committee. We got 13 councillors. It's not like we
yeah.
have 9 councillors and 6 standing committees and there might be problems.
Exactly.
Okay,
exactly.
What about restricting
so
the president
that,
of the council?
I think that's the other one I want to discuss. I'm perfectly fine restricting the president. I'm less fine restricting the vice president, and I'm vice president right now, so I understand there is a conflict there.
Right.
That's fine with me. I only found one place that put vice president in.
I'll just say the president's essentially chairing a committee. The
right.
vice president is
okay.
not.
Okay.
That's why
I'm taking it.
And can we turn B into 2 separate items? To be I'm sorry. I just want things less texty, more bullet points.
Okay.
Yeah.
The president
yeah.
of the council may not
yep.
chair a standing committee.
Yeah. Yep.
Right.
And
no
I got
town
it.
No council
I'm
member.
Right in front of your eyes, that is changing. Okay, and I'm going to take the yellow highlight off because we fixed it.
And again, this is because even though in other communities, which we had all these good ideas,
I'm
no
good.
One's saying they weren't good ideas, it's just that now we're at a point where we're like, nah, let's not do that.
I think it's good to spread out the cherry.
The president part, there, again, in several communities, they automatically do finance.
Okay.
But
I just want to keep moving.
We don't want that, right?
Okay.
We're still in agreement that we
all
don't
agree.
Want the,
yeah,
the chair, to, the
yeah.
president to automatically
yeah, we agree.
Chair
we agree.
Finance. Good.
Yeah.
Okay, in D, I think I need to split it into two because the first is they should meet regularly and then special
yeah.
committees may be held. Right.
Yeah. Or it
special
could be like
special meeting.
I'm looking at C because I'm not looking at. Yeah.
Oh, right.
Yeah.
It could be
oh,
D so. One and D A. D
I'll just.
One and two.
I'll just.
Meetings A and B. Or
yeah, something
one
like
and
that.
Two,
yeah.
Little one, little two.
Roman numerals.
Yeah. That's how charter does it. Why we picked Roman numerals? I don't know.
Yeah.
At least we tried to make things consistent.
Most of the this, I think. Most of the rest was. Boilerplate that we got right from the very beginning from somewhere.
Yeah.
So I don't actually understand what D means. I mean,
what?
D.
Committee shall meet regularly at such times and places as required by the town council or the committee's chair. How would the town council ever require us to do
mm-hmm.
a committee meeting to do anything? I mean, I guess I'm not, I'm.
We could just say committee shall meet regularly.
That's fine.
Yeah.
I like that.
As decided by the committees or, I don't know. There's a,
what's
I like
that phrase?
The charter has some wording for
I want to give direction, but not constrain.
Article 9 is like they shall adopt.
It's the purpose of this is just that people know when we're meeting. Right, and we've coordinated with the
uniform
rest of the
meetings.
World.
All multiple member bodies of the town shall meet regularly at such times and places as they may by their own rules
yeah.
prescribe,
yeah.
unless some other
that.
Provision
yeah,
is made by measure. So
literally
I think you said town council committee shall meet regularly at such times and places as they may prescribe.
Period.
Thank
they
you.
May prescribe.
Got it.
Where was that from? We should put the
912A.
No, I'm not going to. I'm not going to do
it. But it's not. That's multiple member bodies.
Yeah, I'm just taking
we're
it
just
out.
Oh, we're just stealing.
We're just going to steal it from
done.
The charter.
Okay.
Good.
And I'm just going to do committee shall meet. I don't need to long committee meetings. I'm just
yeah.
making
yeah.
simple.
And then special meetings.
And then
of a committee may be held if called by the committee's chair or at the request of one third of the members, but not fewer.
And that was you, Mandy. Wait,
yeah, so that
yeah.
mirrors,
yeah. Yeah.
again, 912A or B in terms of when a multiple member body can call special meetings.
Yeah.
The chair can or...
Call by the chair or by one third of the members thereof,
yeah.
but not fewer than two.
Fewer
exactly.
Than two. And it kind of mirrors what we allowed for the town council, too.
Yeah.
In the charter.
It's good to specify this because there have been big fights in the past about who got to call committee
okay.
meetings, so I'm glad the charter called this out and that we should carry that through in rules.
And then the, you know, this was actually handed to us right at the beginning,
some
and then Manny made an edit or two on it, you know, when we first were given our charge, but we didn't put it in. Committee shall be coordinated
so
with the clerk of the council who will propose.
Yeah, that's that doesn't belong.
Could we just
more,
delete it?
Yeah.
Can we just delete?
Which one?
Yeah.
The under it says shall hold a meeting no later than 60 days after appointment.
Mm-hmm.
I think
and, that one's fine.
And
yeah.
then committee meetings shall be coordinated with. We can just get rid of it.
Just
remove
the whole
second
sentence.
Line.
Okay. And then that was boilerplate also, right?
The notice?
Yep.
I would get rid of the word notice
yep,
because
me too.
We haven't really
yep.
been doing
oh,
that
I like
in this section. But I moved it to just comply with open meeting law requirements.
Say what?
Yeah.
Say what?
The change was committees shall comply with open meeting law requirements. Forget the 48 hours
great.
Or post an agenda. Just.
And can I just put, oh no, I don't, I'll leave it.
And then just separate the notice to a person.
To a person
yeah,
if they require to appear 7 days, I think is consistent.
That's the charter, right?
I just deleted that.
But can we just make it a separate bullet point?
Yeah.
Ah, I see.
That's what I mean. Yeah. If you're making somebody come, it's good to carry that through from where else we have it.
It's in the council. Legislative section says
we're only going to get through one section today. I'm so sad. But it's a big one.
But it was a big one.
And we had it's our first discussion.
What?
So those discussions
5 days
were required.
Is what the charter says.
Which one? Ooh, does it
the
say five?
Notice the town council
to
shall give
annual
notice of not less than 5 days to the representative of all
the
member body, town manager, superintendent, or library director. The notice shall include specific questions on
so
which the council
wait,
seeks information. I'm reading from the charter. Then person called to appear before the council under 2H shall be required to respond.
Okay, so
any question?
No less than five
all
is actually the word
not be required.
Instead of seven.
Five is
it's,
what the charter
it,
is.
But it's no less than
it's
five.
I guess it's five.
I think, my God, I would give a person at least a week.
No, I know the charter's only five.
I know.
If
we want to be consistent with the charter, I'm not sure that we have a purpose for not being consistent with the charter for this.
So
you say no
so
less than.
No less than 5 days.
Business
that
days.
So
not with the charter.
The charter's just 5 days. I think anything less than
seven
is business.
Yes.
I'd have to look at time computation.
So shall give no less than five.
Yes.
Can, and are you okay with Shalini's business days?
No. Computation
because
of time. I'm
computation of time is a
it's
real
defined.
Thing. There's a real
computation
definition
of time
computation.
Is less than 7 days. When the period of time designated is less than 7 days, intermediate Saturdays, Sundays, and legal holidays are not included. So business days doesn't matter because the computation of time in the charter takes care of that.
You don't
okay.
say business days
but
because business
that.
Days is not a real definition.
Right.
Computation of time
days.
Is
okay.
a real definition. We had this long conversation at bylaw review, so that's why it's fresh.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Yeah.
Gotcha. No, but I like the fact that it says no less than,
no
five,
less than
days.
5 days.
That doesn't mean only give them 5 days.
No less than.
Can I fix this wording? Committees, it doesn't work, so can I say no less than 5 days to a person required to appear? Can I just say?
Mm-hmm. Yes. The it may gone.
Right.
Well,
required
who
to
decides
appear?
They're required to appear? I mean, there's kind of a phrasing issue there. So
yeah.
how is it phrased in the section of the charter that we're stealing this from? Andy Jo?
That was my
I think it's.
I'll just do
sentences.
The committee.
I'm looking. Hold on.
I think it's in separate sentences. You can make somebody come.
Investigations.
And you have to give them
the town manager, the town council may require a representative of a multiple member body to appear before the town council to give any information that the town council may require in relation to the minute, blah, blah, blah. So it says the town council may require, and the town manager and superintendent, the town council may require the town manager to provide, town council may require the town manager to appear before it.
And then
so
it has the separate sentence about how much.
And then the
notice
is separate in a separate thing.
And so does it seem odd to just say a person? It gives the impression that we can require people to appear before us.
Yeah.
That's what I'm trying to get at is how it was phrased in the charter
so it was
originally.
Three
this
separate
compelling
ones. It was
to show
a
up.
Representative of a multiple member body, the town manager, the superintendent of schools, and library director. And for superintendent of schools or library director, appear before it at any time to provide specific information on the conduct of any aspect of the business of their respective town agencies that is within the jurisdiction of the town council.
So I have a...
And then they get to choose whether they send someone else.
Right.
Yeah.
All
right.
So a normal human being, we're not a court, we're not
right.
going to put
right.
them in jail. So. This all was applying to, we're asking a head of a department or a head of an agency, you know, the school, to come before a committee. Can we either take it out altogether, or as Darcy just says, what does it mean to say a person? Because it's like dragging people off the street with five days notice.
You've been served.
we didn't say.
You're homeless and we need
and
testimony.
We could mirror the charter and do three separate sort of things, multiple representatives of multiple member
mm-hmm.
bodies, the town manager and the school committee, the superintendent and library director. And or we could just say the town manager, you know, we could always say, I could come up with wording, it gets longer. It's not short, it's long. You might always want to include within the committee's jurisdiction.
That's a good point. because you can't just ask them to come because you're curious
but,
about
but,
something.
But I just heard you also say we're asking officials to come.
Officials, right.
So it's not a person. Town officials. I'm just
because
there's that long description.
Yeah. It's the
school
specific.
Library,
it's a
yeah.
representative of a multiple member body. It's the town manager. It's the superintendent of schools, the school superintendent,
library.
And it's the library director to appear before it
mm-hmm.
on a matter within the committee's jurisdiction.
Mm-hmm.
Other than representative of a multiple member body, everyone else's they can send a reference. They those three individuals can choose someone.
Is it worth considering, as Kathy's busily trying to type all that in, is it worth considering, instead of typing all that in, that we're just trying to say the 5 days notice as a reminder to people in here and then tell them to go read that section of the charter?
We might just say committees shall have the same ability as the full council under
yes.
section.
Yes. Because then that forces you to go
section
read the whole
2.
Thing.
Section 2.8.
Rather than copy it.
For access on investigations and access to information.
Section
yeah.
2.8, do it again.
2.8 regarding investigations and access to information.
That
simplifies it completely.
I was shrieking about including SEC or section instead of the little symbol because some platforms won't.
I did SEC.
So I really appreciate that. And just in case she noticed why you did that.
No, I'm the attorney in me always uses the symbol.
Yeah, makes it hard for the layperson
yes.
to do searching
I
on
get
some
it.
Platforms.
I get it.
But I think that's great because then it says that kind of that. And if
that
you're sitting at a committee,
so you
go and look and see
investigation
what the rule is.
And
access to information. Investigations plural and access to information. It's the title of section 2.8.
Because arguably, if we didn't write this in here at all, some people might say, "Well, I
don't
know. You're not really acting. You're not really the council. You're only
yeah.
a subcommittee." But so we make it clear we're being treated the same.
Okay,
yeah.
Got it. I wrote it. Committee shall have the same power as the council, charter section 2.8.
Under charter section.
Under.
To
okay,
act,
under.
To act in, I don't know.
Under.
Same powers as the council.
Under.
For
regarding
and regarding
investigation
and access to information.
Access to information.
Access to information as set forth in section 2.8, charter section 2.8.
Okay, I'll fix this wording. Right.
Something like that.
With it, because you want within the committee's jurisdiction, so
yes.
in there too. So I'll get
yeah.
that, all of that in this.
And that section has the timeline in it, so we don't have to
right.
put the timeline
then we don't
in
have to put
here.
The timeline in.
Which also forces people to go look at it, because otherwise they're going to be more tempted to just use this shorter version. When it's a complex section, I say make people go read the charter.
Yeah. We don't have to come up with our own wording then.
Yeah.
Let's just follow this.
Okay, good. I'm getting all this out.
Did we decide shall's the right word, Kathy?
Isn't
after all the discussion?
No, we said we're going to decide it at the end.
No, but
for a period of public comment?
Yeah, we...
Shall's the right word? Are we good with that?
Oh, yeah. No, I only see... My shall versus must was only... There were four places in the bylaw that had the word must. Throughout the bylaw, it otherwise said shall.
It should be consistent.
No, those musts were real musts. You know, in the original
yeah.
you know, when you looked at them, you had to do this.
Okay.
It wasn't so much that I thought must was a better word. It was,
yeah.
there were only four instances, and they really were obligations. Not, but in any case, shall... Shall is the better word.
Says shall, and in fact, it says shall in section 912. So shall.
I don't think we used anything but shall on the
yeah.
charter.
That was a good move to try and be consistent. So, was our intention in the more global view to one thing in the section H where it's complicated and we need people to go read the charter.
Sure.
Was our intention ever to add a charter reference to basically the end of every sentence that has one?
No.
Okay. Just being clear.
It was in certain sections we did.
Because some things we've said in here are in the charter and some things obviously
right.
aren't. And so I wasn't. One method would be to every time you use something that's in
right.
the charter would be to cite the charter. I'm okay with not. We just need to be clear when we explain
consistent.
It to people that some of these are exactly the same as in the charter and
mm-hmm.
some are not. And not it's not always, it's not specified unless it's something complex.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
So what did we decide?
So, for example, when we wrote the remote participation policy years ago, there are certain state rules and there are also things you're allowed to do locally. So
right.
every single sentence we either cite the state
right.
rule or
no,
local
I just meant
rule.
Like what are we deciding?
I think what we have been doing, and
yes.
then this is what I think when we do the final review, we can say, do we want to do more of it? We've only been dropping charter section X or Y when it is literally taken from
okay.
that specific place,
got
or
it.
It helps. What this was shorthand for,
got you.
We can do a bunch of things without writing a full paragraph.
Right, because it's there.
So
already.
We didn't
okay.
do all the places where something we were drawing, like the charter says
mm-hmm.
we're supposed to meet regularly. We didn't say charter section, whatever,
mm-hmm.
you know.
That's what I was wondering yeah. about. Is
we're
that,
not,
do we need to?
We're
I'm
not
sure.
doing
it was
that.
More when a
got
timeline or action.
Yeah.
When,
the, when we can't,
yeah.
when so the other way I would think about mm-hmm. it is if we ever wanted to come back for the annual or every 2 year revision, there's certain things we can't change because
okay.
they're dictated by a general law or a charter. There are other things that the charter was
right.
permissive and vague and we're,
mm-hmm.
you know, not, you know,
yeah.
it,
no,
was bro-
yeah.
it didn't say which committee, it was broad.
It,
so
we had to do something, but it didn't dictate how we had to do it.
So,
so
do we want to finish this section, J through N, today, or is there something you wanted to switch gears to, Kathy, because you thought you really wanted to get through something else today?
Okay, well, the issue, I think we've got a couple more larger discussions here that are only one-liners, but it's like, do we want them in or not? So, and we've got 15 minutes left, so maybe I clean this up so there's a more decent version one to look at next time.
Version two.
You know, this is now version one. Version two, and we come back to those. So the, I had, and I'll tell you what the two things are so people can think about it. One, I didn't question the town attorney's decision, but I thought it was odd that if we create a committee that's not already envisioned by the charter. Okay, the charter has some committees that have counselors in it, and it used wording like the council shall appoint these, that if we ever committed another committee, and we have one instance of one so far that had a mixture of council members and residents, I have never seen, under separation of powers, a hired manager appointing a member of the legislative body, and it wasn't because it's normally considered a separation of power. There's an executive branch and there's a legislative branch. And I can't think of any body of government I've seen where, you know, a governor would choose which members of the legislature served on a committee that was. So I wanted to come back to just, we can't change, we got legal advice on that, but I wanted to question that. Then the second
where would
one,
that go?
It's, I have a drafting note. I have it under, where there are committees that are multi-member committees. I just literally put a yellow highlight because I knew it had
yeah.
already been decided and we had a
it's the yellow highlighted on, no, that's not.
It's a number
it's
five.
Five.
I've got
oh,
it just sitting here.
It was five. It's
yeah, but I've got it just sitting here. And then the other one was when we have, and Mandy flagged, which I think is right, we have a few committees named in the charter that aren't committees of the council. And what is the process that the town council uses? And we used a process to get us so we could have a joint, a JCPC. But the process was the president makes us a recommendation and we decide whether we like what her recommendation is. We could take a vote every year on how many people want to be on that.
Mm-hmm.
And if there are more members than not, choose. So those are two things just to come back to. And I provide, it's the same motion I made. Yeah, it's the same motion I made. Yeah, it's under the committees that aren't committees of the council. And Mandy pointed out that the resident,
the residents participating in budgetary
commission,
budgetting commission
is not
essentially
a long,
an ad hoc committee.
It's not a long-term committee. So
no, it'll be done in a year and a half.
So I wanted to just come back and discuss those, but there are probably a bunch of other things in here that we do or don't want.
So I was wondering, could we finish A? I have
okay.
a few things in A
sure.
that
so
might not take a lot of time.
Okay,
so
I'm ready.
We're still in Wait, we're in A of what? We're now doing J through N of item six.
Starting at, is it minutes?
Minutes.
Yes.
Yeah. Okay.
So I want us to take out the this may rotate among members, because of course, like many of you, I'm pushing that we have staff for this.
Exactly.
Because it's
I'm
insane.
I'm waiting for that too.
So we're assigning a clerk, and I don't think we need quotation marks, just capital clerk.
Yeah.
And then everyone knows the clerk can vary from one meeting to the next until we get a real one.
Okay, taking it out.
And then minutes, keep the minutes shall record votes taken by each.
Yes. Yep. That needs to be two separate points. It either needs to be minutes A and B, or it needs to be J and K, because those are two separate concepts.
Okay.
So assign a clerk, record the votes, because the charter says you have to record the votes. That was the one that made me think, do we have to quote the charter every single time? I mean, the citation, and I appreciate that we decided nah.
Okay.
It's not a may, it's a shall.
Creativity is fine. So reporting, my comment is, that paragraph doesn't conform with the packet deadlines we created in the meeting section of the rules.
Okay, so we'll put exactly
the
same.
Packet
okay.
Language into reporting.
Okay,
in
I'm
terms
just
of what reports are.
Ah.
Okay, I'm going to I'm going to yellow highlight because I know what section that is. We did, Mandy turned that back into days.
We turned it into like so many days.
We turned it into days, so we have specific wording.
Yeah.
Okay.
So I would just mirror the wording for that.
The only thing, I'm wondering about the last, well, I'm also wondering about how you compel people if they don't follow the rules. But aside from that, I'm wondering about the last sentence.
Committees are subject
so
to
nothing to report.
I appreciate that we don't want reports that say nothing to report on paper, but based on what? So does that mean that every single do our agendas, again connecting this to another piece, do our agendas assume that every single time the council meets there's an opportunity for every single committee to make a report? If that's true, which I think it is,
just take it out.
Then why do you have to say something if there's nothing to report?
If a committee is not submitting a written report,
then they could provide a verbal.
I'm just saying it allows the clerk to know I'm not waiting on a written report to include in a packet.
So are we saying, so there are a bunch of different ways to go with this, but it sounds like you may be saying that in order to make things move along efficiently, rather than having the clerk pull the chairs to see if they're turning in reports, is that it would be the active duty of each chair to say whether or not there will be a written report.
Yeah.
That does not preclude a verbal report.
Right.
It
right.
doesn't mean you won't have anything to say.
Yeah, that's what I just changed it
but
to.
It's just
the committee is not submitting a written report. They shall inform the president and clerk,
yes.
Period.
Yes.
Period. It's just...
They shall inform the president and clerk, period.
Period.
Yes,
right.
Take
there's
out the no report
yes.
for
it just,
exactly.
Yes, there is no
because
written.
Then that way they can still, because something may have come up since that deadline versus what's
okay.
happening
it's
that
fixed.
Night
it's
at
nice
council, and so they may have a verbal report, oh, we're going to talk about that
fixed.
Next
Done.
Tuesday.
Done.
So just going back just for a minute to minutes.
Sure.
Does the minutes section assume that that's all we have to say about minutes?
So that is different than what public records requires for minutes. Mm-hmm. Public records only requires, minutes under state law only require what the vote was, not actually indicating what member voted which way. So we are altering what state law requires for minutes with that sentence.
Okay,
I'm just suggesting that the AG talked about minutes when she was here in the last, or the, what's her name? Lauren from Casey Law. She talked about minutes, and she said that they need to include a reasonable summary of what was discussed.
So maybe
something
what
like
I should
that.
Do is what Mandy just had me do on the days. We have good language on that up on agenda, on regular meetings.
Summary, yeah.
We have minutes shall be taken. They should include a decent summary, a record. I should just put copy and paste that
either
all here.
Either put it all in there or say minutes
sure.
shall comply with rule.
Yeah.
Yes,
whatever.
I would much rather do that. Send people from here over to that
over
minutes
that
section
and
so
perfect.
They don't think this is the only place that it talks about.
Okay, so
send people over
minutes
there.
Committee meetings shall council meeting, you shall comply with.
I too.
Because then, and that's the one place you're more extensive, rather than having a short version.
We get to cross-reference ourselves, X point X, whatever it is.
Whatever it'll be in the end.
And that's good, because that already has a record of each vote taken by a member, and I, and there shall be a clerk, so we can just get, rid of all of this, right?
Great, and that way, nobody's using just this and forgetting that there's a whole nother section.
Okay, good work, Darcy, good work.
Referral, all my question was, does it belong here, or should I have really included it in the legislative process section?
Yeah, this is a section called.
We actually, so this would be, does a committee, so does a committee have a power duty to cross-refer? Because that's where it is now, otherwise we have it other on your whole legislative process.
Right, my one question was, does this belong in council committees or legislative process? That's another complete different conversation, is can a committee automatically refer to another committee? We started that conversation last week, didn't we?
Yeah.
I'm not sure we've resolved it.
Should I just color code this to come back to the, because the one issue might be just to remove it.
I don't think we ever made a decision that it belonged here.
We didn't make a discussion.
It's just, it was here from January without a discussion as to where it belonged, when we had a much longer.
But now that you've got it in the other section.
Well, I'm not sure I have this direct automatic in the other section.
I'm gonna leave it in here for now, and then we'll.
So that it goes somewhere, but I suspect it belongs over there.
We haven't talked legislative process today, right?
No.
Right.
Okay, so I can move it there and put it there for conversation next week.
I bet it'll scan better over there in terms of,
and
it kind of jumps out at you there.
I can conform it to whatever I wrote there.
And then we can drop N altogether.
Okay.
Because that's just a fact. And I think we actually said
we set it up there. It was kind of duplicative.
Right. The other, if we could go back to reporting for just a minute, I want to clarify something. So that's L now. We keep changing. I get the yellow part is totally cool, and with the last little bit. The first sentence, however, I don't know that there's, are we sure we really want to force committees to do a report every single time? I don't think we do. So I think instead we just alter that second sentence to say something that makes it clear what we talked about earlier, that you got to tell people whether or not you're going to have a report so they can count on it in the packet.
Mm-hmm.
And that's like your responsibility as a committee rather than them having to ask
yeah.
you. But it's totally okay if you don't. And then eventually a counselor might say, how come we haven't heard from that group in a while? Like that would be a totally reasonable thing to ask.
So do you want to... start with, so I'm just thinking committees shall report orally or in writing?
Shall regularly report to the council. Written reports shall be provided to the council president and the clerk of the council, whatever.
Yeah, is regular generic enough?
No, are you saying that the committee will let them?
As needed?
As needed.
Is what I think GOL is using in the charge.
Oh, okay.
As necessary or
right,
as needed.
Because that's where it is. It's in the charges, right? I tried to get us to have specific stuff in the charges that says you're going to tell the council things. So
it's either as necessary or as needed.
Unless the default should be or not, and only notifying when there is a report.
Okay, so I haven't.
I hear what you're saying. You should be notifying if there is a report rather than having to notify every single time.
Every single time.
That makes sense. So.
So it says committees shall report to the council as needed. I'm just going to, and then I'll move up. If there is no written report, they shall whatever. Reports shall be provided no less than whatever days.
Written, and then you can just say written reports shall be reported this way.
Yeah.
Verbal reports may be provided.
At meeting or
something.
You may want to just do it on your own, but instead of having so much communication every week, every time. There is no report. Oh, there is no report. Could we just have the default that they will write when there is a report?
Do we need to say you shall tell them? Yeah, I like that.
Yeah.
Oh,
you don't
like
have
that.
To tell them when you're not. You just better have your report in.
Right. Right.
When
I like that, Shalini.
Right, and then if they haven't heard from that committee, and if the clerk or the president hasn't heard from the committee, well, like, mm-hmm. you really still don't have a written report. It's been 3 meetings since mm-hmm. you had a written report. Then they can ask, but rather mm-hmm. than it being another task for a committee to check off.
Just say written reports are provided by this deadline.
Right.
I think that hasn't been the practice up to now, unless I'm wrong.
Once we have staff support, maybe we will have more regular committee reports.
Once we have staff
support. Then we'll have really regular committee reports, but in the meantime. But I do like the idea of saying, one, it's written reports, that not just reports, but written reports that have to be submitted, you know, in order to do that. But then also giving the option of verbal reports, because mm-hmm. people may well have something they want to just tell some, mm-hmm. characterize in 2 sentences.
Do we want to specify that any time a recommendation is being made to the council for some sort of action or vote, a written report must be provided?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. That makes sense.
I don't know how you work.
Maybe that's a subset of this. So you've got verbal reports, you've got written reports, and you're like, by the way, if you're trying to get the council to do anything, you can't just ask them verbally to do it at the meeting. You mm-hmm. need to have some written support for that.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. That makes sense.
Work.
And then, if something weird comes up, and a committee does try and do that verbally, we can say, well, the rules say X, Y, Z.
Are we gonna
suspend the rule? Is this really that important? And that's why you have rules, right?
Okay.
To set the baseline. It doesn't
okay,
mean
I will clean this
never.
Up, but it's got typos and duplication, but it's basically
we got
committee shall report to the council as needed, committee shall notify the president or clerk if there is a written report, any recommended action must be provided in a written report,
nice.
Report shall be provided X days before. Yeah, I mean, that'll be this the flow
yeah.
of
yeah.
this
yeah.
messy,
yeah.
messy
that makes good.
Thing.
That's good.
I think we just got through A.
Yeah.
Yay!
So that looks very little.
That was complicated. There was actually a lot of stuff in there.
Yeah.
Okay. So.
I'm just going to make sure this is actually in my download.
I want Kathy, who's doing all this work for us, to feel comfortable where we're at. And then I want us to talk about what we're focusing on next time, and then I want to adjourn.
Okay, so we've got, meaning you, are on the April 22nd agenda for liaisons.
Yes.
And the expectation, as I understand it, is
yep.
we already gave a few paragraphs on what we think the process should be, but you will have a list.
Right.
And we have one more meeting, which is next week,
right.
before... So I was thinking maybe you could have that.
I have that ready for
ready.
Us
so we,
for next
we are
Tuesday.
Totally ready
yeah.
so that they will
yeah.
get it
yeah.
by Tuesday afternoon or Wednesday morning for the packets, okay?
Yep.
So, yeah, what else are we doing for the next
So
time?
Then next week, Mandy,
we finish
the legislative
we're finished coming back
this?
To this
so
legislative
we'll
process.
Was completely sort of, there's a lot new in that.
We'll revisit
and then,
council committees.
So we have to finish council committees, and we have to revisit legislative process.
Which is a name, sort of newish.
And then legislative process. And then we had one minor additional thing into thing called meetings, was
yes,
just Alyssa adding a couple
yeah,
notations.
Yeah, I have it uploaded. Revisit legislative process.
Mm-hmm.
I'm trying to get the words right for the meeting posting. Finish council committees, revisit legislative process. I already have the thing about liaisons.
And then final detail on the thing called,
meetings.
Section called meetings.
Yep, that was in today's posting, so I'll
then what I
that.
Said I would do, Mandy, on everything else, so everything but these 3 sections,
mm-hmm.
right? I was gonna continue to do what you started to do and bring them into a document
yep.
Where we've now got the charter references and being charter, sec, period, blah, 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 paren. Try to do that consistently so we can see what it's looking like.
Mm-hmm.
We haven't, if we could get to it, I sent everyone the revised outline, which is just
yeah.
simplified, but Shalini a while ago did values. Both Darcy and I gave her feedback
on
values.
And I've included both of yours.
And so we've got a values appendix to look at, too.
I've uploaded that with everyone's.
Right, so I was going to think that if we could do finish committees, get through legislative, and get through meetings and
happen.
Do values.
But put it down so that will get pushed to the
then
next
we have those.
Liaisons,
yeah.
So values is in the
it's an appendix, and it's a finished document in
yeah.
that we've all seen.
Yeah.
We just have to
so
look at it.
It's a revisit.
Yeah, it's a V2.
So it would be if we could get that done. And liaisons, I think Mandy is going to be one sentence in the rules. You know.
Yeah. Right now, the rules draft says
liaisons to come. Or
well, we've got two different versions: a version I had and a version you had. Either town council may select from among its members liaisons to other multiple member bodies, including school committee under library trustees and other entities, or the town council can designate councilors as non-voting liaisons to multiple member bodies, the school committee, and the library trustees.
Okay, so
and
we have
the charter reference.
Right.
Those are the two options, sort of.
Yeah, and that's sort of covered in the report we gave to town council last week.
Yeah.
So, but in addition to taking that text and making it its own separate report, it's also with some modification of both of those. It's also then the chart of, and that's what I'm bringing back for
what the council's going to adopt for appointing FinCom resident members, which needs to be in this rule. Whereas council
right.
liaisons, one
yes.
sentence is fine,
right?
But because of how the charter is worded, the
right.
process for FinCom resident appointees needs to be set forth here.
Yep.
But we can't drop that in until the council,
right? Which we'll be discussing.
All right, so we just come back to both of those wordings are actually fine with me, so we can just decide which we like better.
They're both in currently B under this B, whatever.
Okay,
so
under
when
this.
When you create the new version. And
so the only change from today's posting, which currently has a whole bunch of boilerplate to cover everything, including liaisons and finance committee in case we were revisiting that, it also said, likely this week, town council committees, legislative process, liaison and ex officio roles, meetings. So all that is still holding true, as well as values.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm terrified, but I think I can just close this down now, right?
After you do all that work.
No. I did the work here, and I downloaded it, so let me just make sure it's sitting in downloads when I go look at the files. Saved at 11:32. Yes, that should be as near to.
It's close. My internet just keeps getting to be smaller and smaller.
Okay.
The longer we sit here.
All right. So that's the plan. And you know, if people, the original work plan, I was looking at it, and if we get to, so we're saying 1, 2, 3. We have 10 working sections now, so we'll be talking about 3 next week. But I'm talking about then having something opened up that has 7 in them. And then if we get these finished, they can be added and values can be added. So by the week after, we could be looking at the equivalent of the first full draft of the thing.
Yeah.
And meanwhile, people would have been able to see the way it looked, the flow
yeah.
of it,
mm-hmm.
and the nomenclature, you know, like if it's rule 4 and it becomes 4.1, then is it 4.1A in parens? You know, like, you know,
yeah.
we're just going to have to figure out what that is. And I wanted then to, when we present it, my hope was we have the document we're presenting and we either yellow shade something where we think it's new, different, creative, or draw attention, or we do a one-page report that says, you know, here we have our draft, please pay particular attention to X, Y, and Z. But so we just keep a track of that mentally on if we want to draw people's attention to something that wouldn't
right.
be necessarily, they wouldn't know to know
right.
what's coming. There might be a lot of yellow, but it's not a hard thing to do
right.
then to read through a document
right.
that
makes it a lot
most
easier.
Of this is just
yeah.
telling you a quorum is 7 people or motions
yeah.
has got nothing unusual
right.
in it. So,
right.
or we could flag yellow shade a whole section title. It's got some stuff in it.
Yeah.
But I think it would then expedite because
yeah.
we're on the timeline. We're getting it a first draft to the council. And then a second draft to the council, you know, once we get their feedback. and then a final version voting and adopted on June 3rd. So we've got a timeline that allows for coming back again and making changes, which is why we have to stick with the timeline we've got, because otherwise we don't have that.
So you're saying we'd be looking at a final, quote unquote, version on the 23rd of this month?
30th.
Yep.
30th?
Well, the 30th is the last time. The 23rd is the first.
Yes. So we're looking at having a draft on the 23rd.
So yeah. If I'm doing next week,
draft
next week is the 6th. You know, I thought something that, like, look at that. Next week would be 7 sections in a document.
Yeah.
And then the 23rd would have everything in the document for the first time, including the value section. And so we could be looking at that, so we could get to something that looks spiffier by the 30th. And
so the plan is the 23rd and 30th, we'll be discussing the whole document as a document.
Yeah, as a whole document. And then the council meeting, there's a meeting on the 6th and a meeting on the 20th, which gives us, if we actually have a decent looking document on the 30th, which was the plan, then it can be in the packet for a group discussion that date. We meet. If we keep a monthly meeting to revise it, to come back with a substantially revised, if needed,
and
by the 20th,
yeah, potentially with a final vote on the 20th.
If it's good to go, and then if there's still something more, the final vote can be on the 3rd.
Mm-hmm.
And if the final vote is a final vote, we basically like it, and our queen of GOL, who's sitting here, says. There's still some GOLs going to have to make sure the notation is right or whatever, you know. But we just need to adopt working rules by June 3rd. Yeah.
You know, we'll have to see what the council wants. My thoughts are, we're kind of a subcommittee of GOL. It probably shouldn't need to go directly to GOL before council adoption. And if there's anything funky, it comes to GOL anyway.
Right. It's just like cleanup that the notation isn't as clear as it could be or something, but any substantive thing has been. So I think we've got enough time as long as we can.
We've got 3 meetings.
Yeah.
So we got 3 meetings before the council
sees it.
For the first time.
For the first time.
And then 3 meetings with the council.
Wait, are we? I can't even remember. Are we meeting every week now?
Yes.
Yeah, so we've got. The 16th will have 7 sections, the 23rd will have everything in it, and then the 30th will be read it again, you know, like any changes we want to make when we look at the whole thing.
So the goal would be to come back on the 23rd, every one of us, with specific things we still want to discuss.
Right,
and it seems like, you know, there's a potential of like long discussion on those things, but if we can just decide to do what we had said, you know,
have an option A, option B, with
our different opinions in the report.
Right, if you go to council that way without us having to argue
especially
about it or
with
just
the first
express our disagreement.
Right, well, it doesn't really make that much difference. I mean, it doesn't.
Yeah, no, there'll be a nice way of saying it, I think, that it's like, you know, some but not all of us liked option A or liked option
and
B. Or
it would be perfect because May 6th or whatever it is at the council, we don't have to have final. We can say, here's 3 things you guys need to discuss so we can come up with final wording
because
we disagree.
We weren't 5 votes on any side
on
of the matter.
Before we come up with the
right.
I like that because it's better than
this.
Saying 3 against 2 or 2 against 1 or an abstention.
Right.
It's just we've got options. We're giving you options on this.
Nice.
And so I will on the things we. We're going
to
give them options anyway.
To them saying,
right,
a majority of us wanted
right.
X, they would still be able to look at it and say, well, we don't agree.
Of course, we're giving them additional warning to look at right away.
We disagreed. We didn't even bother taking a vote because our disagreement was so.
Right.
We thought the policy was so substantial that we thought the first vote should be the full council.
Right. So we'll do just what you just said. That. In the document won't be, this is rule 1.1C. This is 1.1 see with three options, including it doesn't exist, you know,
right.
whatever it is, and we'll be red shaded, orange shaded, something that
mm-hmm.
makes it really stand out. A decision is being made here, as opposed to some interesting things that we all liked and we put in
right. yeah,
that we
right.
want to draw your attention
yeah.
to.
So my point is, we don't have to waste time arguing about it anymore.
Yes, you
right.
got
yeah.
it.
We can just reflect the options.
You got some new things. Sorry.
You got
right.
it.
Should,
you got
should,
it.
Which
we
will be.
We need to find the new
time.
Things
yeah.
to argue about, but
we
identify them, and we
but
actually
one of our defaults can be identify and say this just goes to the council.
Yeah.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
Exactly. We can stop talking about it, and that makes total sense. And so the other question is again, you know, lead time for these things, right? So if what we're trying to give the council is something that is not just a this is perfect, trust us kind
mm-hmm.
of deal, we're giving them that on the 6th that has options
give
and alternatives
exactly.
in it. They obviously, we would like them to have it. Is it realistic for us to have it the Wednesday before the 6th?
Yep.
Even though
yes.
that rule's not being followed anymore.
Yes,
but
because
I would press that our report got issued to the council on the 6th, even if the rest of the packet isn't ready.
Right.
Because it's a lot for somebody who's not been looking at this
oh,
the
yeah.
way we have,
oh, yeah.
for them to try and process
yeah,
it.
Yeah, I think, in my sense, I mean, we can definitively let Lynn know we will be on time. So, but then it should be, you know, however she thinks of the agenda for the 6th has an hour blocked out off for at least the presentation can flag the things we want people to begin a long discussion, if necessary,
right.
take a vote on these things.
And that means then probably the 31st, our meeting the 31st, maybe Alyssa, whoever's going to write the report for the...
Has a draft report
for us so that we can flag things to go in and you're not, whoever's writing it is not tasked with fully writing it between Tuesday, midday, and Wednesday morning.
Right. That's great. So that
so
we would be looking at a draft from you on the 30th
Tuesday,
of the report
30th.
To the council.
Right.
So should we be sending the things to Alyssa, like which we worked on? You know,
things that we want included in the report
yeah.
in terms of highlighting.
Right.
Yes. So next
ideas for
this for inclusion.
Mm-hmm. Why don't you just make a document for that?
Yeah.
In SharePoint.
Yeah.
Yep.
And then we can dump things in as we're talking about it.
Items to flag
too.
Mm-hmm. Items to flag.
Items to flag.
Yep.
Good. Isn't this exciting?
Yeah.
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 I just realizing recently that I won't always have a meeting on Tuesday morning.
We've got only about a month to go, and then we're done with Tuesday morning meetings.
No, when the plea from the downtown parking group came through to the counselors that would you like to put someone on the council, I immediately said, oh, that works perfectly because rules will have ended and it's only a 2-month commitment. So the summer will still be, there will still be a summer. And I can go on my raft in the second week of July without worrying about it. You know, I am really hoping that second meeting in July gets canceled, but I definitely will not be. I will be on a whitewater raft, and
okay,
there will be no remote.
Somebody
want
to move to adjourn?
Yes, I move. We can stop chit chat. I move.
Aye, second.
All right, all those in favor, please
aye.
Say aye. All right.
Aye.